Hello everyone and welcome to this quick After Effects tip on how to sequence layers. Anytime you have an After Effects project with multiple layers, you can automatically arrange those layers in a sequence and a timely manner. Here we have a composition that I want to reveal by using and animating a checkerboard, which has actually been created inside Photoshop. So let's go ahead and jump into Photoshop and examine this file. And as you can see, we have a total number of 16 rectangles, all layers named, and each of these rectangles have a size of 320 pixels by 180 pixels, covering the whole area of 1280 by 720 pixels, which is the size of my composition inside After Effects. The reason I'm creating this checkerboard inside Photoshop is because I want to retain those layers that represent the checkered patterns, which will animate and reveal the composition. So let's go ahead and import this Photoshop file inside After Effects. All you have to do is just right-click, import, import file. Here's the file that I'm going to import. And we're going to import this, click on this drop-down menu. We're going to use the composition retain layer sizes. Click to import, and in this dialog box here, import kind from the drop-down menu, choose composition, retain layer sizes, and leave the rest as is. Click OK. All right, now, here's the newly imported composition. Just double-click on it. And as you can see here, I have retained all the layers exactly from Photoshop, nice and named correctly. And what we're going to do is we're going to animate these checker patterns, right? So if I select those layers in order, then they will also animate in a sequence order. But because I want to make things a little bit more interesting, I want the checkerboard to reveal the composition beneath in a more random way. So we are going to select those layers in no particular order. And so the sequence layers command inside After Effects will actually respect that. So randomly, we're going to select all of these layers. So select one, hold down the control key or the command key on the Mac, and randomly select those layers here that will animate and reveal the composition below. Okay, all of them randomly selected. Now, we're just going to move the playhead just a bit. I want to go by 10 frames, and actually this is a great shortcut here. Control Shift right arrow or Command Shift right arrow. Just going to do it once. There you go, by 10 frames here. And now we're going to trim the out point of all of these layers. And the shortcut is Alt right bracket key on your keyboard or Option right bracket. Do this once. There you go. Then go up to the animation menu, keyframe assistant, sequence layers. I'm going to leave this as is. I'm not going to do any overlaps. Just going to click OK. All right, let's zoom in a bit. Now, if I play and if I scrub the timeline here, as you can see, the checkered patterns actually work. The thing is that some of them are black against the black background. So all you have to do is just click on this icon here to the composition settings. Click where it says background color. Let's go ahead and change the color to white. It won't really matter. We'll do this for our viewing only. There we go. Deselect everything and find the layer that is on the stack, the one that appears the last, which is this one in this case, rectangle 3. All right. So I'm going to click on this and I'm going to go to the add point of this layer, so press O on your keyboard. And then as you can see, the rest of the layers actually have disappeared. But we want to keep the layers. We want to keep the layers visible. So we're going to select all the layers, so Control A or Command A on the Mac, and then we're going to trim the out point of all of these layers on the specific time, on this current time, which is this one. And again, the shortcut is Alt right bracket or Option right bracket. Okay. Now, all this, the rest of this area here is unused. So I'm going to trim my work area. So first, you're going to press the letter N on your keyboard. That will change the end of the work area to the current time. This is the current time here. So press the letter N on your keyboard. There we go. And then just right-click and trim, come to work area. Very nice. All you have to do is just go back to the slides. And then we're going to drag this inside our composition, like so. And if I scrub this, it works, but it works in a reverse way. So all you have to do is just make sure that this composition is selected. Go up to the layer menu, time, and reverse the time. Time, reverse layer. Let's go back in the beginning and then just press the space bar to play the animation. And as you can see, we have a nice animation in a sequence and timely manner in a very easy way. And so this is just an example of how creatively one can use the sequence layers command inside After Effects.